It's been said that a smart person learns from their mistakes, but a wise person learns from the mistakes of others. Looking at how on-set virtual production has been used in the past can give us that wisdom. So, what are some of the prime use cases for this technology? There are plenty of environments that can work well in a virtual production scenario, but there are also ones that don't. Moving vehicle and transportation work, as well as window replacements, are a couple examples of popular applications. Any interior scenes with a lot of interactive lighting or reflections, exteriors of cities, hard-to-get-to landscapes, caves, and spacecraft cockpits are all highly popular use cases for this type of shooting. The time of day when the scene takes place may also inform your decision. Using virtual production can extend the time you have to shoot during golden hour and dusk, sunrise, sunset, or a foggy evening. You can shoot at night all day long, so no need to shoot into the wee hours of the morning. Your crew will probably appreciate that.
Para a direção, filmar no LED é parque de diversões. Eu outro dia eu mudei de ideia. Eu falei, putz, será que essa cena não era melhor se fosse noturna? Aí você corre no roteiro, olha e transforma ela em noite, aqui, no set, sem ligar pra ninguém. O que eu acho mais legal disso é que você tem a chance de fazer, por exemplo, uma cena de duas páginas, de três páginas, que se eu tivesse numa praça, numa locação, o sol ia cair, ia nublar. De repente ia chover.
Posso ficar 8 horas filmando o crepúsculo, né? Acabou meu horário de filmar, eu posso voltar no dia seguinte.
Sério? Parabéns!
Your actors will also appreciate the ability to see and interact with the environment in real time. Allowing them to immerse themselves in the scene can result in more authentic performances.
It would be a totally different experience if we're doing this on green screen. It just illuminates literally everything. You see the whole landscape in front of you and the lighting, and so you're really looking at the sea.
It creates, you know, the perfect lighting, you know, the perfect colors. It's just a perfect environment for the actors to interact with rather than just having to imagine it like we used to do when we were working with the green screen.
Of course, there are also some types of scenes that are less suited to this style of shooting. For example, big camera moves can be tough to pull off on LED volumes. You'll also need to be careful of large objects casting shadows onto the wall or onto the physical set. That being said, there can always be a creative solution for pulling off these types of shots. Fire and animals on the wall are limited in how realistic they may appear and shouldn't be the focus of the frame. CG water and detailed close-up foliage can also be tricky to make look realistic. So a good rule of thumb is to keep these things in soft focus.
Virtual production is not a silver bullet. It's not going to solve all of the world's problems, and it's not going to replace anything and everything that we do in traditional filmmaking. But it's a tool that we can use that can help solve problems for us.
Mom, look! Look what I found.
Think about the needs of your project as a whole, and you may find that shooting on a stage and using these techniques will open up a world of possibilities for what you can create. But you don't have to take my word for it. Remember that the technology is constantly evolving, so drawbacks that we face with using these techniques today may disappear over the next couple of years. You may be watching this video from the future, and we've already found solutions for these limitations.